Good morning, everyone. This is Gail Dudley with your news in motion. Thought I'd have some music as we come on this morning. I do not own the rights to this music, so Facebook, please don't take it down. So good morning to everyone. Hopefully I can see you today. Good morning, Marion. Good morning, Kim Kills. Good morning, Pastor Alex. Hopefully I can see you. Yes. Good morning, Kim Hill, Tracy Burrs, Latrice Jones. Good morning. I thought I'd have us a little bit of music coming in. I do not own the rights to this music, but it's Friday and this hits today. So let's just listen to a little bit of it, okay? This is Joyful, Joyful, the remix. Good morning, Deborah Johnson. Good morning, Kenya. Let's just get our juices flowing this morning, okay? Again, I do not own the rights to this music. I thought we'd come in dancing, you know. Since y'all couldn't see me singing yesterday. What's up? Good morning, everyone. I do not own the rights to this music. I just wanted to start Friday off a little different. It's Friday morning. We saw a new day. Good morning, Kim. Good morning, F. Kim Edmondson. Good morning, Kelly Lee. Good morning, Stephanie. Good morning, Demia. Good morning, Deborah. Good morning, Paige. I thought I would give us some music. Good morning, Bishop Bellinger. Good morning, Carolyn. Good morning. Good to me. I'm glad you're dancing. Good morning, Kim Hill. Yeah, you know me. Everybody. Come on, y'all. Let's get the juices flowing. Great to see you too, Bishop. Come on, y'all. What have you done for me lately? Ooh, yeah. If I could dance, I would be jamming right now. We watch us over everything, so we sing. Joyful, joyful, Lord, we adore thee. It's Friday, y'all. It's Mimosa Friday. Hey, Diane, Ladybug. Good morning, Patricia. Fill us with the light. Fill us. I can't sing, so y'all just forget that part. I thought we would just come in jamming this morning. This is the remix of Sister Act 2. It's a part of the medley that is on YouTube. What's in my mimosa? Trust me. What's up, Michael Priestley? Kenya Nicole? Fill us with your light of day. Light of day. There y'all go. Y'all can't ever say I never did that with y'all. I hope y'all had enjoyed the party this morning. Good morning, everyone. This is Gail Dudley with your news in motion. Today is Friday, December the 11th, 2020. I am so happy to be able to see you all again. Yesterday was interesting, but we made it through. All right, before I even get out into what's happening with the news, y'all, one of our community, our family members who join us every morning, we're sending prayers and condolences to Jeffrey Allen James in the passing of his mom. If you follow him, he made a post on yesterday. So let's just be thinking about him. That's right, my Marion, party with a purpose. Let's just be thinking about him and his family today. John Gore, you came after the party. We was jamming. I was singing and we were dancing, dude. You missed that. You're going to have to hit the replay. Just hit the replay. Good morning, Mary Jenkins. Good morning. So again, y'all, Jeffrey Allen James, if you saw his post yesterday, probably mid-morning or early afternoon, his mom passed away. So if you follow him or just put a note here on the thread, I'm sure he'll see it. Just tag him. Again, that's Jeffrey Allen James. We want to be praying for him and his family in the passing of his mom. Yeah, John, you missed it. We were partying. I was singing and dancing. You missed it. Yeah. Thanks, Kim, for praying for them. Good morning, Judy. All right, y'all. So I'm trying to think if I'm going to give y'all the, I think I'm going to give y'all the answers now, and then we'll go into news. Let's have some more fun this morning, and then we'll go into the news. First of all, y'all's answers had me cracking up, literally. I was laughing so hard at you all and your answers. Y'all were just funny. So here are the answers to the Christmas trivia, and we have a winner, and I know that she's on here already. All right, the first question was, in Home Alone, where are the McAllisters going on vacation when they leave Kevin behind? The answer is Paris. Y'all were saying the Bermuda, the Bahamas. The answer is Paris. And again, we're going to get to the news in a moment, and I have an inspirational message for y'all talking about lifting of heads. So if y'all can stay to the end, stay till the end. All right, question number two, which popular Christmas beverage is also called milk punch? I think all of y'all got that correct. It's eggnog. All right, what did the other reindeer not let Rudolph do because of his shiny nose? Some of y'all's answers were absolutely hilarious. And again, it was join in the reindeer games. But the way y'all were answering that question was absolutely hilarious. Question number four, what are the two other most popular names for Santa Claus? I was laughing. Y'all were giving me one. I said two. And that is Kris Kringle and St. Nick. Question number five, what words follow Silent Night? All of you got that right, Holy Night. Question number six, in Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol, what was the first name of Scrooge? Most all of you had that right, that was Ebenezer. Question number seven, what did Frosty the Snowman do when a magic hat was placed upon his head? Y'all's answers cracked me up with that too, but y'all all got it right in your own language, how you said it. He began to dance around. Question number eight, according to the song, what did my true love give to me on the eighth day of Christmas? Eight maids of milking. Question number nine, how do you say Merry Christmas in Spanish? And I said you also had to spell it correctly. And again, y'all, that's Feliz Navidad. Question number 10, what is the best-selling Christmas song ever? Y'all just flunked on this one. Y'all should have known better. Bing Crosby, White Christmas. 11, question number 11. Three of Santa reindeer's name begin with the letter D. Y'all were making up some names. At least I know y'all did not Google Dancer, Dasher, and Donna. People were saying Dorothy. Somebody said Donald Trump. Y'all did say that, y'all did. Question number 12, what is the highest grossing Christmas movie of all times? Y'all, Home Alone. Home Alone is the top grossing one. All right, y'all, so the winner of the $50 shopping spree on Kim Carter's website, Sanctuary Girl, and I will inbox you the direct link, so I'm sure you're on that particular site. All right, y'all, who do y'all think won? Y'all know I gotta take it longer. Who do y'all think won? Her name begins with a D, and no, it's not Demia. Her name begins with a D. Who do y'all think won? Come on, y'all, it's a woman, and her name begins with a D. Come on, somebody tell me who won. No, Hester is not you. You did not win. Your name does not begin with a D. And Antoinette, your name does not begin with a D. You said you got eight right. Demia, nope, it was not you, Demia. And Demia, they had me cracking up talking about you were saying that you weren't cutting up. Nope, Deborah didn't win. Nope. Come on, y'all. Nope, not a Deborah. It's not a Deborah. The second letter is U. The second letter is U. D-U. The second letter is U. D-U. Nope, it's not Deb Johnson. Nope. Deborah, they really want you to win this, but nope, Deborah did not win. Marion, nope, it's not you. Nope, it's not Diane. The second letter is U. So D-U. D-U-A. D-U-A. D-U-A-N-I-T-A. I just go ahead and give it to you. So congratulations to what is, and I hope I pronounce, yep, that's it. That's it. You got it, girl. Do Anita. So she received it. Good morning, Rhonda Clark. Good morning. You receive it. So I will inbox you all the information. Congratulations. Congratulations on that. And we decided to go ahead and get a second winner as well. And the second winner is John Swan. The second winner is John Swan. So you'll both get it. You'll both get it. All right, y'all. Times 2020 Person of the Year is President-elect Joe Biden and Madam Vice President-elect Kamala Harris. So they received the 2020 Person of the Year. All right, y'all, they are literally getting on my nerves. Get this, y'all, get this, y'all. An emerging $900 billion aid package from a bipartisan group of lawmakers has all but collapsed. You guessed it. Hi, Rhonda, I miss you too, girl. You guessed it, y'all. That Mitch McConnell, I don't know why y'all didn't vote him out in Kentucky. He said that they're not going to support this. They're not going to support it. They're not going to support it. He wants more in there for corporations. He wants more in there. No, not John Gore, John Swan. Y'all crack me up. Hi, Charles Beverly. They're just stuck on it. They're not going to let this go forward. Understand this, y'all. Please hear this. Now, this is serious. It expires at midnight. It expires at midnight. And so the government will more than likely face a shutdown by Saturday morning, meaning tomorrow, Saturday morning. So y'all, we need to pray. We really need to pray, because then they'll go home, like I've been saying all week, on their private jets to their multi-million dollar homes with their cooks, their nannies, their whatever else, their maids, whatever. And they'll go on and light with life as usual. And again, I'm not hating on that. If you have that, rock with it. But if you have a responsibility to make sure you are taking care of your constituents, be sure to make sure the bills are passed, that a relief package is available, because you won't even come back before the eviction piece happens on the 31st of December. So come on, y'all, exercise what you said when you put your hand on that Bible to take care of your constituents. You have a responsibility to uphold. Yes, corporations need money. Yes, the airlines need money. Yes, restaurants need money. Yes, all of those people need money. But if those of us who are on the streets do not have the money to spend in these establishments, it's not going to make a difference anyway. So come on, y'all. Where is the responsibility? And Mary Jenkins, because you put this on your page, I'm going to say this publicly. Mary Jenkins is going through a situation right now herself. And again, I would not share it if it was not already on her Facebook page. She was denied for assistance because she is the founder of an organization that takes care of people. What? When I read that, Mary, I wept with you. I can only imagine what you're dealing with and what you're going through. And they asked her the question, well, you know, why don't you go work for a cancer organization instead of running your own? Because that's not what God called her to do. She's doing her assignment. And Mary, if I can speak this to you this morning, because you are walking in your anointing and you're doing your purpose and you're doing your assignment and you're being obedient to God, you're going to get what God wants you to have, and you're going to probably end up with more benefits and more financial resources and more resources than any man could have ever given to you. When I say man, I'm talking man or woman. So keep your head up, Mary, and we're supporting you and we're praying with you in this time. Y'all, there's been so many of us, even with small businesses, that have been denied. When we get people like Tom Brady, who took his million, well, I don't know if he took his that $1 million, but he received $1 million from the PPP, and then he bought a yacht for $960 million last week. That doesn't add up. And that's after he received the million dollars after he signed a $50 million
contract with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. It doesn't add up, y'all. It doesn't add up. And that's why it's not just about our election days. It's not just about us voting, but it's making sure that we're doing something about it over and over and over again and staying in people's faces, sending those emails, making those phone calls, y'all. It is so important. There is so much on the line with this Georgia election on January the 5th. So don't think just because you don't live in Georgia that it will not affect you. Trust me, it does. That's why we got to get to work and we got to make sure that two main people, now I'm endorsing them. I don't know what side of the aisle you stand on, so you do what you want to do. But what I know is that Warnock and Ossoff need to be elected into that office on January the 5th. That will create a deadlock in that Senate, which means Madam Vice President will have the final say-so. Yeah, let that sit in for a moment. So y'all, that's what's before us right now. And we have to be mindful about this. We have to be mindful. And so when we deal with the silliness from out of Texas, y'all, there are 106 Republican lawmakers that have signed on to this ridiculous legislation, this bill going to the U.S. Supreme Court to overturn the election. Are you trying to say that we don't have a voice? No, we have a voice. And we need to rise up, y'all, and start writing into our legislators, our lawmakers, the people we voted in, and say, enough of this. Enough of this. And watch this, y'all. It's targeting those of us who are black and brown. And I know we have some white brothers and sisters that watch this video, and I appreciate you, and I know you are our allies, and I thank you for that. But just for this moment, I need to say they are targeting the black and brown demographics. That goes back to we talking about the census. The reason the census, the U.S. census, were so important, because for the next decade, they will determine how they're going to break things up, how many seats, the congressional districts, the lines. Y'all, when things come up, we got to stop being afraid to respond. Go ahead and respond and then deal with the fallout later. So now we have a decade of whatever's about to happen. That's why it's so important going back to Georgia that we must do our part regardless of where we live in the U.S. to make sure those two people get in. Again, then Madam Vice President will always be the deciding factor of every vote. Can you imagine the power that sister will have? Yes. But yeah, we have 106 Republican lawmakers trying to overturn an election that is talking about overturning it in areas where there's those people who look like me and the majority of you. That shouldn't be okay, y'all. That shouldn't be okay. And speaking of black and brown sisters, y'all, Tiffany Haddish said, not today. She said, I ain't having that. Tiffany Haddish shared the reason why she decided to turn down the opportunity to host the 63rd Grammy Awards pre-telecast ceremony. Well, she said she declined the offer after the Recording Academy told her that she would have to pay for her hair, her makeup, her wardrobe costs, in addition to receiving no compensation on the live stream event. She said, no. She goes on to say, I love her quote. She says, it's like a guy asking you to go on a date, but telling you that you have to pay for it. Not today. Not today. Speaking of money, y'all, Airbnb, jumping investors said pretty much how high. The company shared their surge of 112% in its first day of trading to reach valuation of $86.5 billion. President-elect Joe Biden, he has named Susan Rice. He is really holding on to that, what he said, as a national security advisor. Lulu Mom, get this, y'all, Lulu Mom. That's the yoga pants, the leggings or whatever. Y'all, they jumped 22% from a year ago. Why? Because people can now have a board meeting in their yoga pants and leggings. So that's what people are buying. That's what people are buying up all over the place. So they jumped 22%. Ben and Jerry's, y'all get this. Ben and Jerry's unveiled a new Colin Kaepernick-inspired ice cream flavor called Change the World, WHIRLE. Y'all, so hats off to Ben and Jerry. Hats off to Ben and Jerry. Have y'all noticed Colin Kaepernick may not be on the field playing, but he is making some rounds and he is making the money. So he hasn't lost anything. And I'm so glad he continued to stay in the fight to say, no, I'm going to continue to watch my people, and I'm going to continue to stand against injustices everywhere. And this is not just in the United States. It is around the world. So hats off to him. Y'all, by the way, I told y'all a couple weeks ago about Snapchat. They're giving away $1 million a day ever since November 23rd. But they're saying they're finding it difficult to get people to get on there. Y'all, we should really consider getting on Snapchat. $1 million? $1 million. So that's still happening. All right, y'all, 12 days is canceled, y'all. Ellen DeGeneres, y'all, she tested positive for COVID-19. She tested positive. So her daytime talk show is on hold. She revealed her diagnosis on a tweet on yesterday, writing, "Hi, everyone. I want to let you know that I tested positive for COVID-19. Fortunately, I'm feeling fine right now. Anyone who has been in close contact with me has been notified, and I am following all proper CDC guidelines. I'll see you again after the holidays. Please stay healthy and stay safe." The spokesperson for the studio, Telepictures, announced that the show has been put on pause until January while she recovers. So people were asking about the 12 days of Christmas, because y'all know she gives some serious prizes during the 12-day Christmas. And they said, it's 2020, you'll have to wait till 2021. So people don't know if that means she's going to come out and do something for the new year, or if it will be the 12 days of Christmas at the end of 2021. All right, y'all, the coronavirus numbers. I hate to keep giving you these, but I got to give them to you. Y'all, confirmed cases, 16,039,393. Deaths by today, if it hasn't already happened, there are 299,692, which means we're going to hit 300,000 over the weekend. Y'all, pray for those families. Pray for those families. I cannot imagine that during the holiday. I cannot imagine that at all. So pray for those families. They need us to send them prayers of strength, prayers of condolences, prayers of just grace, prayers of mercy. All y'all, right, let's celebrate the recovered. 9,330,865 have recovered. Yeah, I'm going to give y'all this direct quote from the Associated Press. It says the U.S. recorded 3,124 fatalities Wednesday, the highest one-day total yet. The stunning death toll eclipsed American losses on the opening day of Normandy invasion during World War II, which were 2,500. So we have surpassed that number. And it surpassed the death toll of September the 11th, 2001, of 2,977. So it has done that. It also has gone beyond y'all, the peak of 2,603 deaths that happened on April the 15th in response to the coronavirus in New York City. Y'all, more than 106,000 people have been hospitalized this week, 106,000. Again, this is a direct quote from the Associated Press, and that was recorded by Heather Hollingsworth and Marion Renault of the Associated Press. Let those numbers sink in, y'all. Let those numbers sink in. And you decide. And that one doctor, when he said, okay, you don't want to follow what we're asking you to follow. He said, so then answer this question. Who did you kill today? That just hit me. Who did you kill today? Y'all, those words, when that doctor spoke those words, he said, okay, y'all don't want to listen. You don't want to wear your mask. You don't want to stay home. You don't want to social distance. He said, who did you kill today? That one hit me. It makes us have to pause to ask the question. Yeah, who did I kill today? Who did I kill today? I'm singing "So Sorry for Your Loss," Kim. Tell me about that, y'all. I'm just now singing that. If somebody can just let me know what that is, or I'll go through the thread later. And which Kim are we talking about? Please let me know. Thank y'all. I'm glad I saw it. I just see Latrice thing that says, "So sorry for your loss, Kim." Yeah, John, COVID is a B. I go back to what Nora said on CBS News when she said, we're in COVID hell. Kim Hill, condolences to your families. Y'all, somebody tell me what's happening with Kim Hill, please. Thank you. And I'll try to keep an eye out on that. If not Kim Hill, I'll read the thread afterwards, and I will Okay, Kim Hill lost a cousin. Kim, yes, we will definitely be praying for you. Y'all, thank y'all for responding to that. Thank y'all. Yeah, Kim Hill, we will be praying for you. So y'all, the U.S. panel endorses widespread use of the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine. The Food and Drug Administration is expected to follow the recommendations issued by its experts. The group concluded that the shot appears, keyword there appears, safe and effective against the coronavirus in people 16 and older. Now, y'all, it says a final FDA decision is expected within days. Shots will then be going to care workers, healthcare workers and nursing home residents. Now, y'all, I want to tell y'all, because I was reading, combing through and see what some of the other countries are doing. Austria's prime minister says not so fast. His name is Scott Morrison. His name is Prime Minister Scott Morrison. And he said his government won't rush to approve of the Pfizer vaccine. Why? Because he wants people to have confidence in the product. Now I'm reading a direct quote from him. He says, researchers have said that they are abandoning their own potential vaccine because it produces false positive results in HIV tests. Now that's the first time I've seen that, and I was combing through other articles and I'm seeing that over and over again. So there's something with the HIV test, if I'm reading this correctly, that is associated with something that is in the Pfizer vaccine. Now, I know, Kenya, you're on here, so maybe you can speak to that or give us an article for us to see later. If you do have something, just tag it in the thread so that we can review that. But yeah, Prime Minister Scott Morrison is saying, no, we're not rushing anything. There are still some tests we want to see. So for the win, y'all, for the win, for the win, for the win, for the win. Starbucks will promote, and I know some of us are still hating on Starbucks. We still haven't gone back because they treat us wrong, but get this, y'all. We got to give them a hand clap for this. They will promote board vice chair Melody Hobson to chair in March. Thank you, Kenya. Thank you. Which will make her the only Black woman to lead the board of directors for S&P 500 company, according to Bloomberg. In October, get this, y'all, she's a bad sister. In October, Melanie Hobson donated money to establish a residential college at her alma mater, Princeton University. The college will be the first at Princeton to be named for a Black woman. She gave her own donation, like, here, just name it my name. So she a bad sister. And then Melanie Hobson was on the Forbes World's 100 Most Powerful Women list this year. And her name is spelled M-E-L-L-O-D-Y, Hobson, H-O-B-S-O-N. So she gets the win today. All right, y'all, it's Friday. That leads me to our, good morning, Lori, our inspirational message. So y'all, this morning I was listening again to some worship music, not hating, but holding them accountable, still not going to Starbucks. Girl, I'm not either. But I'm gonna give it up for the sister. But they don't need my money. No, I'm with you, Demia. This morning I was listening to some worship music once again and came across You're the Lifter by Ricky Dillard and Tamala Mann. And of course, y'all know I went in. The Lifter of the Head. So therefore, I want to encourage you today. I'm even encouraging myself. I got encouraged while I was listening to the worship music this morning. And what came to me was, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, the everlasting doors. For the King of Glory shall come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of Glory shall come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord God Almighty, the Lord strong in battle. Lift up your heads. I look to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. Y'all, some of us are walking around. We got so much stress on us. We're reading the news. We're watching the news. We're hearing about another hashtag of Casey Goodson, and we get discouraged. We're looking at our finances. We're getting discouraged. We're looking at the holidays, and we're getting discouraged. But I'm here to encourage you. He's the lifter of our heads. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up. Listen to this, y'all. If you would just lift up your heads and look around and see the beauty of Jesus, you can't stay in a spot that will keep you downtrodden. You can't stay there. You can't stay there. You can't stay there. And I know it's hard when we're dealing with people who are dying from COVID. We're dealing with people who have been sick with COVID. We're dealing with people who have job loss. We're dealing with people who are facing eviction. We're dealing with people that has so much going on. But y'all, if we would just lift up our heads, if we would just lift up our heads, look at it this way, and this may be small to you, but it's big to me. When I look at these 106 Republican lawmakers, I'm not sitting there going, you're crazy. I'm sitting there going, thank you for showing me who you are. So I'm lifting up my head. I'm looking at them so I can see them one by one and say, okay, thank you for telling me who you are. If I kept my head down, I wouldn't know who they were. See, in our lives, we have people all around us. If we would lift up our heads, we can see the manifestation of God and the anointing and the power that is on our lives. See, we have to stop running from what God is calling us to and walk into what he has destined just for you and for me. Y'all, we have to lift up our heads. We have to find another way to spend money. We have to find another way to love. We have to find another way to do what we do. Okay, so you lost your job? Okay, I get it. I get it. I'm sure that's difficult. I'm sure you're looking at everything before you. But here's my question. What gift do you have that we can sow into you? Lift up your head and look around and ask yourself the question, what makes my heart sing? What makes my heart beat? What am I really passionate about? And go out there on the limb and start it. But you can't do it with your head down. You have to lift up your head. Okay, this is going to be hard, but I got to go here anyway. You may have lost someone to COVID. You may have lost someone to another illness, to another disease. But the question is, do they want you to keep your head down, or are they calling you to lift up your head? I'm encouraging you today. Yes, grieve. Grieving is good for the soul. Yes, grieve. But at the same time, lift up your head. When you keep your head down, you're missing a whole lot. But when you lift it up, you begin to see. I said before, and I'll say it again, even when your back is up against the wall, don't look at that as a negative. Don't look at it as a negative. When your back is up against the wall, you have the foresight to see what's ahead. So go ahead and do your survey and begin to walk out in power and in confidence and in boldness. You can't do it with your head down. You got to do it with your head up. So when your back is up against the wall, it gives you an opportunity to survey and to see what's in front of you so that you can come forward with boldness. That's my message for today as we go into this weekend. That's my message for today as we go into this weekend. Y'all, don't forget Sunday. Don't forget Sunday. I gave y'all 18 Christmas carols. If you're willing and want to, just go out on your porch, your patio, your balcony, and start singing Christmas carols. 7 p.m. Eastern time, and I jacked that up. Y'all, I said 3 o'clock on the West Coast. No, that'd be 4 o'clock on the West Coast. But just go out, y'all. Do something, because singing those Christmas carols may absolutely lift up somebody else's head. Don't forget, we have that one family. We are dealing with one family. Each of us are focusing on one family. And if you're just joining us, it's not too late. Focus on that one family today, and we go to the end of the year, which is December 31st. They don't even have to know that you're praying for them, that you're lavishing them with gifts, that you're encouraging them. They don't have to know what it is that you're doing. If you want to reveal yourself, fine. Don't forget to send cards to those on the front lines. They don't necessarily have to be Christmas cards, because Christmas cards, somebody at the front line may not even believe in Christmas. And that's not the reason why we're doing it anyway. We're sending cards to encourage them. All right, y'all. So y'all know this is Mimosa Friday, so I decided to do something new. I decided to start giving y'all a mimosa recipe on Mimosa Friday. I got this recipe from Adrian, and it's off of Delish. It's the peppermint bark mimosas, y'all. You need some semi-sweet chocolate chips. They need to be melted. You need 3 candy canes. You need to crush those up. You need a bottle of champagne or sparkling cider. You can spike it or not. And then you need 6 whole candy canes. You take the melted chocolate, you pour it onto a saucer. You take the peppermint that you crushed up. That's on a different saucer. You take your champagne flute. You dip it in the chocolate that's been melted. And then you dip it on the crushed up peppermints. You turn it upside right. Then you take the extra crushed peppermint. You sprinkle it in the bottle, in the bottom of the flute. You take either the champagne or the sparkling cider. You fill the glass. You take the whole candy cane. You put it inside and you say cheers. That's all you got to do. Sit back, put your feet up. Have a great time. Have a great weekend. Everyone, I am Gail Dudley with your news in motion. I am so grateful that you decide to tune in with me Monday through Friday at 7:25 a.m. If God willing, I will be right back here on Monday morning at 7:25 a.m. Eastern time. I love y'all. Again, we had 2 winners. John Swan was 1 winner. And I'm going to pronounce this name correctly. Duanita, did I say that correctly? Please let me know that. So what I'll do, I'll inbox you the information, I'll inbox you the code, and you can go shopping on the Sanctuary Girls website of Dr. Kimberly Carter. Yeah, it does sound delicious. It does sound delicious. It sounds delicious. So everyone, you make it a great weekend. Don't forget, if you Christmas carol, John Swan said yes. If you Christmas carol on Sunday, please get permission first. Please do a video and then upload it to your Facebook page so that we can all just sit back and have our heads lifted up. Remember, if you find yourself looking down, lift up your heads. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, the everlasting doors, because the King of Glory shall come in. Who is the King of Glory, the strong God, mighty in battle? Lift up your heads. Y'all make it a great weekend. Mwah! I love you. I'm Gail Dudley. Peace out.